para sa ating mga bisita sa Cordillera Administrative Region na imbag nga bigat kada kayo amin, Apo. I am very pleased to share with you these two studies that have already been introduced by our moderator. Let me just retitle the first presentation, and it's about the role of social networks in accessing and utilizing weather and climate information and in informing extension services in upland farming communities. Okay, so just a short background, this study is part of a broader collaboration between PIDS and the ASIAR, or the Australian Center for International Agricultural Research, and with funding from SARDI, or the South Australian Research and Development Institute. Okay, can you proceed to the next slide, please? Okay, so ano ba yung rationale behind this study? So basically, we want to contribute to the design of strategies for communication, for information campaigns, and even extension services by using already existing norms and structures as portrayed by social networks. So when we were considering this study, we observed that usually yung ating mga strategies and design ng ating mga programs, they're designed uniformly. Kumbaga, there is less regard for heterogeneity. And perhaps this is because due to our limited resources. And also we found out firsthand that when we visited Atok, there's really very poor mobile phone signal in Atok Benguet. And therefore, it's very difficult. That was 2019, like that's very difficult to access the internet. And that really kumbaga affects yung pag-access ng mga information and other resources that can be obtained from having internet connection. We also learned that there are very few workers, extension workers or agricultural extension workers in the province of Benguet. Back then, we obtained that 134 lang yung kanilang AEWs or agricultural extension workers, whereas they're serving tens of thousands of farmers. So when we were talking to them, they really expressed their desire for better approaches for reaching farmers and disseminating information. So why do social networks matter? Next slide, please. Okay, so basically they matter because social networks serve as structures or norms within which people operate or behave. Next slide, please. And in the social network analysis lingo, we use these contagion models to inform our analysis. And what these contagion models say is that yung rate ng spread of a particular property, actually ang origin nito sa disease, yung spread ng mga disease like pandemic, the rate of the spread of any property like a disease or even information or innovation, it's a function of the density of the community network. So for instance, yung isang network ay mas dense siya compared dun sa isa, mas dispersed or mas fragmented yung isa, yung rate of spread of anything dito sa mas dense ay mas mabilis kesa compared dun sa kabila. So if you want to know how information can be disseminated effectively and efficiently, we can take advantage of existing arrangements which are determined by the network of social relations and interactions. So to continue, no, contagion models say that the more cohesive yung, kumbaga, mas compact yung pagkaka-relate or pagkaka-connect ng mga tao dun sa isang lugar, that allows for faster diffusion ng or faster spread of that information or even disease. So if you are looking for a particular approach in which to, kumbaga, i-inject mo yung information or gusto mong malaman ng maraming tao yung isang program like microcredit, you have to strategically, kumbaga, inject that idea or knowledge, and you have to know the most central units or actors in the community. Next slide, please. Okay, so We also use this theory of social influence. So, for instance, if you're closely related to many people, you have such a big clan, you know, there's higher possibility of social influencing among members of that group. And that encourages, you know, people to act on the information that you are spreading. So there's trust, kumbaga. Next slide, please. Okay, so when we say social structures or systems like social networks, what are we dealing with? So for instance, I'm just showing you various types of graphs that we use in network analysis. For instance, dun sa right side, you can see density and may pinapakita siyang magkaibang density. May isa 0.18, yung isa 0.13. So ang ibig sabihin nito, if you're going to inject something in A, the rate of spread would be faster because the density is higher. Density is basically the number of actual links as a proportion of the total possible links within a network, within a bounded network. So ganun lang naman yung idea. So we want to show how such structures can be used when we are like strategizing in our education or information campaigns. Next slide, please. These are just basic network analysis terms. I'm going to skip them na lang, and I can go back to them if there are questions later. Next slide, please. So there are network parameters or measures na matatawag. Pag sinabi kong that household or that person is very well connected, there are a lot of meanings to that. And they can be objective. They are objective measures for that. So for instance, may degree. Yung degree is just your number of friends. So if you have, or number of relatives. If you come from a very big family, basically yung degree mo, malaki na siya. Kasi to begin with, you have a big family. And if you have many friends, definitely you are very, kumbaga, very influential dun sa iyong network. There are also terms that are called ibang ways of portraying connectivity, like betweenness. So parang ikaw ay nasa gitna ng madaming households or madaming friends. So kumbaga, ikaw ay isang broker. Yun yung iyong role dun sa network. So there are lots of these, and later on we will see these terms again. Next slide, please. So what are the purposes of the social network analysis that we did? Why are we looking at it? By knowing the structure, now we can speculate about the rate of diffusion, as I've already mentioned a while ago. We know from theory and practice that the diffusion would be a lot faster in more cohesive systems, and less would be for those who systems that are less cohesive. So we can also develop strategy for information dissemination that is more efficient, because we know that the actors who can possibly we can identify the actors who can possibly help us in the dissemination of information and more efficiently, kasi we look at their strategic positioning within the network. Similarly, we get to know who the peripheral actors are. So sino ba yung marang nasa gilid-gilid lang in terms of the social sphere, yung walang masyadong kakilala. So and therefore we can devise strategy that may work for them, that can be effective. So from the social network analysis, we can get the parameters at the individual level. Can be individual person, can be individual households, that we can also correlate yung mga researchers dito, if you are fond of like correlating it with other variables through a regression analysis, that can also be done. So it's very useful as a tool. Next slide, please. Okay, so because we have more information now about an actor's in interaction with agents, because dun sa network natin, pwede nating ma-identify kung sino yung nakapag-interact na with extension workers, then we can then gain some understanding of the extent of reach of these agents, of these extension workers. So we can evaluate, so did past efforts work in terms of reaching farmers or households that are more central? Or pwede rin kasi ang na-reach nila ay yung mga mas nasa periphery, which is also okay kasi kung hindi naman sila laging kumbaga nagbe-benefit sa mga programs. We can also use this for enhancing yung current efforts or future efforts. So where do we go from here? Where can we allocate resources to improve the outcomes of our programs? Okay, next slide, please. So basically the objectives is to be very quick now, because I only have like 20 minutes for this study. Okay, the objectives, we examined the social networks in Atok Benguet. We determined the central and peripheral actors. Central meaning sila yung mas well-connected, peripheral yung hindi masyadong connected, nandun lang sila sa mga, kumbaga, outskirts ng ating social network. We examined also the relationship. Paano ba nagko-correlate yung network centrality or being well-connected, and how are they related with yung access and utilization naman ng weather and climate information, because that's really important for building resilience. And we also assess the extent of reach of extension workers. Next slide, please. So this, the study area is the Atok, and then we selected three sitios. It's proper Pauay, Tulodan, and Macbas. Next slide, please. So just to show you the pictures that we've taken during the field work. Next slide, please. These are the geocodes of the household respondents for proper Pauay. The next is for Tulodan, and the next is for, ayan, Macbas. Okay, there was a site selection criteria that we implemented when we were brainstorming for this. We talked to our partners in Atok, of course, with Benguet State University, because sila yung partner namin sa pag-collect ng data. And what we wanted really is for a full enumeration of household within a community, and we want those communities to be, kumbaga, separate dun sa iba, the rest of the community, either kunyari by river, major road, or mountain. Kasi what we really want is to, kumbaga, to isolate that area, and we are able to identify kung saan yung boundary niya, so that magkagawa kami ng full enumeration. Ayan. We also obtain the inputs from our municipal agricultural officers and other officials in the area. Next slide, please. So the survey was done by our partner university, Benguet State University. They were the ones who hired the enumerators, and they conducted the study in the last week of 2019, last few months of 2019. Next slide, please. There were challenges, of course, in conducting the study. So we also documented this in our study, in our paper. There were problems, I think, during that time. May mga nagkaroon ng scams dun sa area. So medyo, medyo hindi masyadong free, or medyo hesitate, nag-hesitate yung mga tao na sumagot. So it wasn't easy, but it's really interesting. Okay, so just to show you the survey instrument that we use when we say social network analysis, how did we collect those data? So this is the questionnaire, or the module for getting their social relations. So you can see from the left, yung kanilang mga references. So we both obtained the social relations of the house for each household, that for the household head and that for the spouse. And then meron naman tayong parang sexes nila. So maganda kasi, even in the analysis, we have examined the gender dimensions. But essentially, you can see under the columns here, ano yung relation nila, identify nila yung mga household. Pag in-identify yung mga household, may household control number yon. And so we've also identified the types of information that they shared, weather and climate information. We've also looked into their resource sharing, sino household na nag-share ng resources, and even advice, and even, I think, health information. So medyo rich yung data na to. And next slide, please. These are the set of the wide set of social relations data that we have collected. So ang dami, my friends and neighbors. Ito yung mga long term. We wanted to get yung mga medyo long term na, para ma-associate namin to dun sa kanilang behavior. So parang hindi siya yung tipong may simultaneity dun sa relations and then their activity. So we also took work-related relations, also of course the kin, or the family relations, and other social networks. We also obtained that. Next slide, please. Okay, so these are the characteristics of the study areas. When we were looking at this, we had a good, kumbaga, combination ng mga areas, kasi merong proper Pauay, who is relatively accessible, compared to the other, but compared to a typical sitio sa Pilipinas, definitely hindi siya hindi siya ganun. So, compared to the two, mas accessible siya. And then, Tulodan is less accessible. And Macbas is the least accessible of them all. So, para maganda yung, ano, may comparisons. And then, the two sitios under Barangay Catubo, they also have like higher poverty rate than proper Pauay. These are important later on when we are looking at the results. Next slide, please. Now, so what are the characteristics of the social networks? Okay. Next slide. Yeah. Okay. So these are the inter-household social relations of the three sitios. And you can see na parang the dots or the small tiny squares there, each square correspond to a household in the sitio. And you can see like these big balls of networks. And what that says is that, well, there are a lot of opportunities for social interaction and therefore for social influencing. You can see several actors, several households there that are nakalinya sila. So they are, we call them isolated nodes. They're not related to any of the households, either by friendship, by family relations, by anything. So they're isolated nodes. So when we look at their density, we can see na pinakamataas si Macbas. Siya yung pinaka least accessible na area from the city center. And yet, it has the highest density. And this is consistent with studies, the literature wherein yung mas rural areas, mas ano sila, mas socially cohesive compared to those in relatively more urban areas. So yun yung nakita namin dito. But let's not, if you look more closely, Macbas has more isolated nodes than the other two. So yung kanyang, that network, that ball, that graph of social network, it's kumbaga, relatively cohesive, but you can see yung challenges for our, for our extension workers. Madami din isolated nodes dito sa Macbas. Okay, next slide, please. Okay, so these are just objective parameters that maybe perhaps I can also talk about later in the Q&A, but I won't have time to go through them. Next slide, please. Okay, so when we look at the different information that they're sharing, we came up with these different networks. So if you can see, parang hindi masyadong visible, but there are quite differences between or among these types of networks. So yung WCI stands for Weather and Climate Information. And then you have Peer Advice and Resource Network, and then you have Health Information Network. So you can see there are some differences across these types of networks. And it's really important, to look into the differences. And actually, etong part na to, hindi pa rin namin masyadong napagpag-aralan kasi ang daming data. But essentially, what I want to show here is that when these networks differ from one another, and there can be ways in which we can take advantage of the differences. Next slide, please. So ito naman yung networks by type of weather and climate information, because we also have the new ones in the study. Makikita natin dito, yung pag-share ng information, mas common sa typhoon kesa dun sa ibang types of information na binibigay ng PAGASA. So for instance, yung sa El Nino, mas konti yung network, mas maliit. And then mas madaming isolated nodes doon. And of course, itong mga narratives and even the non-PAGASA products. So yung common is yung typhoon, yun yung mas pinag-uusapan nila. But we also know that it's important also for them to share things and share information about these others, other information that can help them in their farming activities. That is for, I think, proper Pauay. The next one is for Toludan. And the other one is Macbas. So you can see the variations there. Next slide, please. Now we go very quickly on the correlates of network centrality. So, okay, so as I've mentioned earlier, there are different ways to measure connectedness. Yung degree kanina, I've mentioned, tell me how many friends you have. Ganun siya. Yung may isa pa, yung eigenvector centrality naman is, it's not how many you have, but it's who you are connected with. So if you're connected with a very, very influential person or household in your community, then you have a high eigenvector centrality. And then yung betweenness I've already mentioned a while ago na parang nandun ka sa gitna ng mga households, your kumbaga yun yung broker. In information networks, those units that have high betweenness score, kapag natanggal sila doon sa network, sa information network, talagang ano na siya, madidisrupt yung lines of communication. Ganun siya ka-importante. So, sa atin, pwedeng sabihin na ito yung mga, maybe Marites or something like that. So, may mga ano, so when we say that household is well-connected, there are objective measures for that. And what we did, next slide please, is to do a regression analysis and then use this connectedness measurements as dependent variable para malaman natin sino ba yung mga highly connected dun sa area and ano kaya yung mga characteristics nila para pag naghanap ang ating or nagplan or nagstrategize yung ating mga agricultural officers and extension workers, kumbaga ito okay, so ito madali lang, ito na yung target natin kasi ito daw yung kumbaga ito yung mataas yung kanyang centrality and i-influence natin siya to spread the news and disseminate to their kin and to their friends. So ang nakita namin is that is consistent all throughout and positively correlated with network centrality are the age of the household head, the number of vehicles owned, the asset index is negatively correlated, and yung kanilang, see, we also obtained a measure or a variable about distance to the places they frequented. So yun yung mga naging significant variables. So age of household head, basically, kung medyo matanda ka na or matagal ka na dun sa area, so kaya madami kang ano, madami ka ng kilala and madami kang kamag-anak and madami kang kaibigan. Yung vehicles owned, we noted that since Atok is a very physically, kumbaga, yung kanyang constraints in terms of the geography, you really need vehicles to go around the area, and therefore that helps you enhance your, kumbaga, your connectedness or your being related to as many people as possible. So asset index, we found that the higher the asset, the lower the yung kanilang centrality, meaning that, so if you're approaching kumbaga yung mga mas well to do din sa area, they're not necessarily the most central in the area. So basically ito siguro yung mga alalaki ng land holdings, medyo hindi na sila masyadong kikipag-associate dun sa area because probably they don't they have other means, you know, to or they have other crowd. Okay, so those are the and then distance to place, of course. So if you we found that if you are nearer to the areas of congregation, then you are more central. You are well connected in the community. Next slide, please. So we also analyze access and utilization of weather and climate information. And next slide, please. Yeah. So we found that those who have access and who are utilizing the weather and climate information in their farming activities are more likely to be older household heads. They are more likely to have more experience in farming, and they have access to credit. Yeah, so yun yung mga naging ano. And then we found out that if you are highly connected in the community, you also have higher probability of accessing and utilizing the information on weather and climate. Next slide, please. So mabilis na lang ito. Sasa, I have only nakuha ko na yung time ng kabilang study. Okay, so very quickly, siguro I'll just illustrate na lang one sitio here. Okay, so ito po yung sabi ko kanina, yung network. Pwede nating ma-identify kung sino yung nakapag-interact na with our extension workers. And kasi gusto natin makita kung effective ba yung naging strategy or paano natin pa ma-improve yung strategy natin by looking at this graph. Okay, so this graph, how to read this graph? Yung pink or yung red? Sige, red na lang. Yung red dito, they are the ones who have already interacted with agricultural extension workers. Yung blue, hindi pa sila nakapag-interact. I think yung mga white, those are part of the network pero hindi sila nakasama sa survey. Because yung survey na ginamit natin, meron din siyang list na pinagbabasehan na. So when we went, when the enumerators were there, parang may mga nadagdag na. So basically, what we want to see here is that we want to see if yung mga red, sila din yung malalaki na squares. Kasi yung laki niya, it is proportional to the yung kanyang degree centrality. So mas malaki yung size niya, mas well connected siya dun sa community. So we can see naman here that yung mga red, malalaki naman yung, although hindi lahat, but basically yung parang mga pinakamalalaki dun na squares ay red sila, which means that past efforts must have targeted or must have, you know, I don't know, intentionally or not, they have reached to the farmers, farming households that are more centrally positioned within the community. What we also want to see here is that the red must be scattered throughout the social network, meaning na hindi sila nandun sa kabilang side lang, so isang family lang na malalaki na well-connected yung sama. So hindi siya ganun. We can also see that it's well scattered, and so that the opportunity for them to influence their kin and to spread the information that the extension workers might have given them is better. So mas maganda yung spread niya. So that's how we look at it. Next slide, please. So ganito din sa Tulodan. In fact, kalat na kalat yung sa Tulodan, and even the isolated nodes they were able to reach. Next slide, please. Dito sa Macbas, medyo madaming isolated nodes kasi hindi nila na-reach. And then, if you can see, pwede nandun lang sa mga ibang sites. May mga part, may mga madaming blues na sa gitna. So yun mga tipong hindi nila masyado, hindi pa nila na nakakausap. So, next slide, please. Let's go to the conclusion na lang para mabilis. Naku, I have already exhausted my time. Okay, so in terms of the, this is just our, okay, sorry. Okay, so for conclusion, we found varying extent of social cohesion, possibly because or possibly based on physical context, and consistent expectation. Remote communities are relatively more socially cohesive, although that's only based on the density. It's not a perfect measure of cohesion. We need to pay attention also to isolated nodes, especially in areas. And contrary to expectation, that there would be clusters, even communities near the kumbaga yung mas hindi naman central business district, but yung areas of congregation, you know, they can also be connected. Low nga lang yung density, suggesting opportunities for social influencing. Next slide, please. And physical proximity and mobility are likely to be the key determinants of centrality. And central actors are those living near venues of interaction. Peripheral ones are those living far from venues of social gatherings. The most affluent families are not necessarily the most central actors. Next slide, please. And centrality is a significant factor in access and utilization of weather and climate information. Okay, and then recommendations. I think you can just go through this, but we need to improve the crafting the approaches by taking advantage of the social network results or results of the social network analysis that we have just mentioned. So let me now go through the next.